Hello, Bachcha Party. Welcome back to the channel. I am Yaminder Savia, your standard 5th maths teacher. We have already completed our NCERT solution. Now, this video is related to important topics or concepts of this chapter. So, let's start. Chapter name is Parts and Wholes. What do you mean by it? It is nothing but fraction. Fraction. We have to study about fraction in this entire chapter. We have already done some examples in our NCERT solution. So what is fraction? It is nothing but part of a whole. What do you mean by it? Let's take an example. If I have this cake. And you are two friends. Let's say Bunty and Bubbly. Bunty and Bubbly want to eat this particular cake. So, we divide this cake into two equal parts. So, in this particular cake, there are two parts. So, as you can see, this cake is divided into how many parts? Two parts. So, we have to write parts below the line. In this cake, how many parts we have made? Two. And Bunty and Bubbly get how many parts? One part each. So above the line we can write one. This part is 1/2 and this part is also 1/2. That is half and half. Okay? So such a type of number is known as fraction. It is nothing but part of a whole. We have entire whole cake from which we have separated or divided into different parts. This same cake can be divided into, if I draw a same cake and I can divide this cake into four parts. So now how to write this in fraction? We have to, how many parts we have divided the cake? In four parts. So we have to write below the line four. Out of four, if I take two particular parts of a cake, how many cake we have taken? Two. So above the line we have to write two. But if I have take one part only, out of four, if I have take only one part, then how to write in fraction? Total parts are four. So we can write four. Just remember, the whole is divided into any number of parts. That number of parts you have to write below the line. We have divided this whole cake into how many parts? Four parts. That's why I have written four below the line. If it is divided into eight parts, then we have to write eight below the line. Okay? And how many pieces we have taken? Only one. So this is 1/4. Okay? Are you clear with that? But now remember, this above the line number is known as numerator. And the below number is known as denominator. Numerator and denominator. Okay? So any number which is written in the form of numerator divided by denominator, that is in the form of 1/2. Again, any number that is written in the form of numerator divided by denominator, such a number is known as fraction. Okay? Are you clear with the concept of fraction? Any number which is written in the form of numerator divided by denominator. And how to write fraction? If we divide the whole into parts, then we write it as a fraction. Okay? Is it clear? Okay, students? Now, if you have given value like this, 4 divided by 2. You can write this in the fraction form as 4 by 2. Okay? You have to write 4 into numerator and 2 into denominator. Let's take another example. If I have 15 by 3, so I have to write 15 in numerator and 3 in denominator. Is it clear, students? Can you write such a division in the fraction form? Practice this. 4 divided by 1 and 10 divided by 2. Okay? Solve these two sums in your notebook. Is it clear? Let's take another example for fraction. If I have a chocolate, and if I divide this chocolate into two parts, then our fraction will be 1 by 2, 1 by 2. Okay? And out of which I have taken only one part of a chocolate, then we have only 1 by 2 of a chocolate. Okay? We have taken the same chocolate. And if we divide this chocolate into 3 equal parts, 1, 2, 3 equal parts. In how many parts this chocolate is divided? 3 parts. And from which we have taken only one part. So this one, this part is also 1/3 of the chocolate. And this part is also 1/3 of a chocolate. You have to remember this. The particular object or a shape is divided into as many parts. That parts we have to write in denominator, and from that particular parts, whichever parts we are taking, that we have to write in the numerator. Okay? In this particular chocolate, we have taken only one part. That's why we have written 1 by 3. But if we have taken two parts from this chocolate, then we have to write it like 2 by 3. Okay? Is it clear? If this chocolate is divided into 4 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, then each part is of 1 by 4. 4 parts, that's why I have written 4 in the denominator. And each part is of 1, that's why 1 by 4, 1 by 4 and 1 by 4. Okay, but out of which if we have taken 3 parts of a chocolate, if I have taken 3 parts of a chocolate, then it will be 3 by 4. Is it clear? The next concept is equivalent fraction. Let's understand this concept with the help of example. I have taken 4 rectangle. Okay? I have taken 4 equal rectangle. So, let's divide the first rectangle into 2 parts. And out of which I have taken one part. So, since the total number of parts is 2, so we have to write 2 in the denominator. And we have taken only one part. Therefore, we have to write 1 in the numerator. We have taken the same rectangle. And let's divide this rectangle into 4 parts. Okay? 4 parts. And we take 2 parts from it. So, since it is divided into 4 parts, we have to write 4 in denominator. And out of 4, we have taken how many parts? 2 parts. Therefore, we have to write 2 in the numerator. Let's divide this same rectangle into 6 parts. Okay, we have taken our same rectangle. Each and every time we have taken a same rectangle. First we have divided it into 2 parts. Secondly we have divided it into 4 parts. Now we have divided same rectangle into how many parts? 6 parts. So we have to write 6 in the denominator. And out of 6 we have taken how many parts? three parts. So we have to write 3 in the numerator. It is the 3/6 of the rectangle. This is the 2/4 of the rectangle. This is the half of the rectangle. Now in the last rectangle, we divide this rectangle into 8 parts. We have divided this rectangle into how many parts? 8 parts. So we have to write 8 into denominator, and out of which we have taken 4 parts. How many parts we have taken? 4 parts. Therefore we have to write 4 in the numerator. So as you can see, we have divided same rectangle into different number of parts. But if we take the half, if we take the 2/4, 3/4 or 4/8, all the rectangles are half. So can we say that 1 by 2 is equal to 2 by 4? Yes. Here it is 2 parts, but we have taken half. And from this 4 part we have taken 2 parts, which is exactly equal to half of the rectangle. In here also, we have taken 3 parts out of 6, but this 3 parts is also equal to half of the rectangle. But in the end, we have taken 8 parts, out of which we have taken 4. And that 4 part is also is half of rectangle. So we can say that 1 by 2 is equal to 2 by 4, equal to 3 by 6, equal to 4 by 8. Such a fraction are known as equivalent fraction. That means the fraction which has same values are known as equivalent fractions. Okay, now let's see how to find equivalent fraction for a given number. If you have given a 1 by 2 fraction, how we can find equivalent fraction for this particular fraction number? You have to just multiply this fraction with the same number. You have to multiply denominator and numerator, both. You have to multiply numerator as well as denominator with any one number. You can multiply it with by 2. So if we multiply 1 into 2, what we get? 2. And 2 into 2, what we get? 4. You can also multiply it by another number, same number, let's say 3. If we multiply 1 into 3, what we get? 3. And if we multiply 2 into 3, what we get? 6. If you multiply given fraction with same number in numerator and same number in denominator, you will get list of equivalent fraction. You have to just change this particular number. First we have taken 2, then we have gained equivalent fraction 2 by 4. Then we have multiplied it by 3, then we get 3 by 6. Now let's see if we multiply it by 4. 1 4's are 4 and 2 4's are 8. So in this way you can find equivalent fraction for any given number. Let's take another example. If I multiply this by 2, 3 2's are 6 and 4 2's are 8. Now let's change this number. If I multiply it by 3, you have to remember this. While multiplying, you have to multiply numerator and denominator with the same number. Okay? So, as you can see here, I have multiplied numerator as well as denominator with 3 only. So 3 3's are 9, 4 3's are 12. Let's multiply it by 4. 3 4's are 12, 4 4's are 16. So for this given number, that is 3 by 4, these are the different equivalent fraction. For this given number, that is 1 by 2, these are the different equivalent fraction. Now you have to find equivalent fraction for 1 upon 4 and 3 upon 5. This is your homework. Okay? Now let's see how to find out whether a given numbers are equivalent fraction of each other or not. Let's say if I have given two numbers, 1 by 2 and 2 by 4. We have to find whether these both fractions are equivalent fraction of each other or not. So how to find that? We have to just do cross multiplication. So what is cross multiplication? We have to multiply this denominator with this numerator, and we have to multiply this denominator with this numerator. Let's say if we multiply 4 with 1, 4 ones are 4, and if we multiply 2 with 2, 2 twos are 4. If this both multiplication are equal, that is both side are equal, then we can say that this both fraction are equivalent fraction. Let's take another example. If I say 1 upon 3 and 3 upon 9, if we do cross multiplication, that is if I multiply 9 with 1 and 3 with 3, 9 ones are 9 and 3 threes are 9. These both are equal, that means these both are equivalent fraction. So in this way you can find whether a given two numbers are equivalent fraction or not. The next topic is types of fraction. So the first type is like fraction. As the name suggests, like means same. If you have a fraction number with same denominator, as you can see here, in 1 by 2 denominator is 2, in 3 by 2 denominator is 2, in 7 by 2 denominator is 2. If the denominator are same, such a fraction is known as like fraction. Let's take another example. In this example, all the fraction number have denominator as 5. Okay, so if denominators are same, then that fraction is known as like fraction. Second type is unlike fraction. It is exactly opposite of this. If the denominator have different number, denominator are not same, then that fraction is known as unlike fraction. If denominators are not same, such a fraction is known as unlike fraction. Okay? The next type is proper fraction. So what are the proper fractions? Let's say 1 by 2, 3 by 5, 2 by 4. As you can see here the numerator is less than denominator. Okay? In fraction, if numerator is less than denominator, such a fraction are known as proper fraction, in which numerator is less than denominator. Okay? In proper fraction, you have to remember this condition. If numerator is less than denominator, as you can see here, 1 is less than 2, here 3 is less than 5, here 2 is less than 4. So in such a fraction, if numerator is less than denominator, that fraction is proper fraction. You have to write 3 more examples for proper fraction in your maths notebook. Okay? Now, fourth type is improper fraction. As we have earlier seen, like and unlike. Unlike is exactly opposite of like fraction. Same way, the next is improper fraction, which is exactly opposite of proper fraction. That is, if you can see here, 7 by 2. Here, numerator is greater than denominator. Okay? The fraction in which numerator is greater than denominator, such a fraction are improper fraction. As you can see here, 7 is greater than 2, 4 is greater than 3, 11 is greater than 3. So a fraction in which numerator are greater than denominator. Okay? Numerator are greater than denominator, and proper fraction numerator is less than denominator. Is it clear, students? Now next And the last type of fraction is mixed fraction. So what is mixed fraction? As the name suggests, it is mixed. So what do we are mixing? The number, whole number and a fraction number. If a number is given like that, then such a fraction is known as mixed fraction. Combination of whole number and fraction. Mixed fraction is the combination of whole number and fraction. So such a fraction is known as mixed fraction. Is it clear, students? So these are the main five types of fraction. I hope you are clear with all the types of fraction. The next important topic related to fraction is conversion. You are able to convert mixed fraction to improper fraction and improper fraction to mixed fraction. Let's see how. There are simple steps which you have to remember. So let's first study about how to convert given mixed fraction into improper fraction. We have example 1 of 2 by 5. You can read mixed fraction as 4 of 6 by 3. Okay? 1 of 2 by 5. If you have given 3, 4 upon 2. 3 of 4 by 2. Okay? Is it clear, students, how to read mixed fraction? So, let's see how to convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction. So, to convert, you have to simply follow this step. Step number 1. In step number 1, you have to multiply denominator with whole number. You have to multiply denominator with whole number. So, denominator is 5 and whole number is 1. 5 into 1, which is equal to 5. This is step number 1. In step number 2, after multiplying, if we get result 5, then we have to add that result with numerator. We have get 5. So we have to add that result with numerator. So what is the numerator here? 2. So we have to add 5 plus 2. That is 7. So in step number 1, we have multiplied denominator with whole number. We have get answer as 5. And in step number 2, we have to just add numerator to the answer. Okay, is it clear till now? So in last step, in final step, we have to just rewrite the given fraction in improper fraction. So how to do it? We have to write denominator as it is. What is denominator here? 5. And in numerator, we have to write result of our step 2. That is 7. Is it clear? In step number 1, we have to multiply denominator with whole number. In step number 2, we have to add result with numerator. And that result we have to write in numerator in the last step. And denominator remain same. Let's take another example. Here, what is the step number 1? We have to multiply denominator with whole number. So here denominator is 3 and whole number is 4. So we have to do multiplication. 3 multiplied by 4. 3 fours are 12. Now in step number 2, we have to add this result with numerator. Step 2, 12 plus numerator is 6. What is the answer? 18. Okay? And simply in step number 3, we have to write improper fraction. For that, we have to write first denominator. Always remember, denominator remain same. Here denominator is 3. So here also denominator will be 3. And in numerator, we have to write result of step 2, that is 18. So for this mixed fraction, your improper fraction is 18 by 3. And for this mixed fraction, your improper fraction is 7 by 5. So you can write 1 of 2 upon 5 equal to 7 upon 5. And you can write 4 of 6 upon 3 is equal to 18 upon 3. So in this way you can convert any given mixed fraction into improper fraction. Is it clear, students? You have one homework. You have to do 2 of 5 by 3 and 1 of 7 by 5. You have to do these two examples in your notebook. Okay? Now let's convert any given improper fraction into mixed fraction. So what is improper fraction? A fraction in which our numerator is greater than denominator. As you can see, 9 is greater than 5. As you can see, 7 is greater than 3. So we have to convert this improper fraction into mixed fraction. So let's see how to do it. This is 9 by 5 is nothing but 9 divided by 5. So first let's calculate 9 divided by 5. That is 5 ones are 5. Remainder is 4. So this is our remainder. This is our quotient. And this is our division. So if we want to convert improper fraction in mixed fraction, we have to first do normal division, and from that division we can write mixed fraction. So to write mixed fraction, we have to always first write denominator. As we have seen in this particular method, denominator always remains same. So here also denominator will remain same. So denominator is 5. So here also denominator remain 5. Okay. Now remainder will become your numerator. Remainder will become your numerator, and your quotient will become your whole number. Is it clear? Remainder will become your numerator and your quotient become your whole number. Is it clear, students? Let's take another example. That is 7 upon 3 is nothing but 7 divided by 3. So let's divide it. 3 twos are 6. 1. Is it clear? So what is remainder? 1 is our remainder. 2 is our quotient. And 3 is our division. So how to write mixed fraction? Denominator always remains same. So denominator is 3. So here also we have to write 3. Our remainder will become our numerator. Remainder is 1. So it will become numerator. And our quotient is 2. So quotient becomes our whole number. So in this way we can convert improper fraction into mixed fraction. I hope you are clear with these two methods. Next is simplest form. So what is the simplest form of any given number, or how to find simplest form for any given fraction number? Let's see. If you have given fraction number 2 by 4, how to find a simplest form for this number? You have to just see whether a given numerator and denominator are coming in a same table or not. You have to divide numerator as well as denominator with the same factor. Okay? You have to divide numerator and denominator with the same factor. That means if these both are coming in a same table or not. Let's see. 2 and 4. Does they come in a same table? Yes. In the table of 2. 2 ones are 2 and 2 twos are 4. So simplest form for 2 by 4 is 1 upon 2. Is it clear? You have to divide numerator as well as denominator with the same factor. That is, you have to see whether numerator and denominator are coming in the same table or not. Let's take another example. 10 and 15. Does they come in the same table? Let's see. In the table of 2, 2 5s are 10, and no 15 is there. Let's take a table number 3. 3 5s are 15, but in the table of 3, 10 is not coming. Let's take a table of 5. In the table of 5, yes, they both come. 5 2s are 10 and 5 3s are 15. So, 5 2s are 10 and 5 3s are 15. So, the simplest form for 10 upon 15 is 2 upon 3. Okay? If your numerator and denominator are divided by same factor, then you can find simplest form for that particular fraction. Let's take another example. 8 and 16. These both are coming in the table of, they are coming in the table of 4 as well as they are coming in the table of 8. So you can divide it by both. Let's divide it by 8. 8 1s are and 8 2s are. So simplest form for 8 by 16 is 1 upon 2. Okay, let's take another example. If 3 and 9 are coming in the same table, yes, 3 1s are and 3 3s are. 3 1s are and 3 3s are. So simplest form for 3 by 9 is 1 upon 3. So in this way you can find the simplest form for any given number. There are some fractions for which you cannot find simplest form. Why? Because either numerator or denominator are not coming in the same table or they are not divided by the same factor. Let's take an example of 7 by 9. No, there is no other table in which 7 and 9 are coming together. So, for this 7 by 9, you don't have any simplest form. Similarly, for 11 by 7, 11 and 7 are not divisible by any same or common factor. So, the simplest form of 11 by 7 is 11 by 7 itself. You cannot simplify this further. Is it clear, student? How to find simplest form for any given number? Okay? Okay, students, so the next and the last topic of this video is comparison of fraction. Okay, how to compare given fraction, whether it is greater, lesser or equal. So let's see, if you have given two fraction number, out of which is greater and which is smaller, how can we find that? If the denominator are same, as you can see in our example number 1, both denominator are same, that is 3 and 3. We can directly compare its numerator and we can identify which fraction is greater or smaller. In this example, since denominator are same, we can directly compare numerator. So 2 and 4, which is greater? 2 or 4? 4. So from that we can say that 4 by 3 is greater than 2 by 3. This is applicable only if your numerator are same. Let's take another example. Here 1 by 2 and 7 by 2, which is greater? As I have said, if denominator are same, here also our denominator is same, that is 2 and 2. We can directly compare its denominator. So 1 is greater or 7 is greater? Obviously 7 is greater. But the problem occur when denominator are not same. In our last example, the denominator are not same, that is 3 by 2 and 2 by 5. So for that, how to compare it? For that, we have to first make denominator of both numbers same. And how to make denominator same? We have to see table of 2 as well as table of 5. In both the table, if some common factor is there, then we have to multiply it by that common factor. So in the table of 2, 2 5s are 10, and in the table of 5, 5 2s are 10. So we have to multiply 2 by 5. Since we are multiplying denominator by 5, we have to also multiply numerator by 5. So in step 1, you have to make both the denominator same. For making 3 by 2, for that we have to see both the tables. Okay, in the table of 2 and in the table of 5, does this both table have any common number? Yes, 10. 2 5s are 10 and 5 2s are 10. So Here we have to multiply numerator and denominator with 5. So let's do it. 3 by 2 multiply by 5 upon 5. 3 5s are 15 and 2 5s are 10. Similarly, for this fraction number, we have to multiply denominator by 2 and numerator by 2. So 2 2s are and 5 2s are. 2 2s are 4 and 5 2s are 10. Why we are multiplying it by 5 and why we are multiplying it by 2? Because we have to make denominator common. Okay? Denominator is 10 and denominator is 10. So we can say that 15 upon 10 and 4 upon 10. For this both fraction, denominator are same. So now we can directly compare its numerator. So 15 is greater or 4 is greater? Obviously 15. So we can say that 15 by 10 is greater than 4 by 10. And 15 by 10 is number for which value? 3 by 2. So from that, we can say that 3 by 2 is greater than 2 by 5. In this way, you can compare any given fraction number. If the denominator are same, then there is no problem. But if there is a change in denominator, you have to first make denominator same by multiplying common factor. Okay? Then you can directly compare after the denominator become same. I hope you all are clear with part 1 topics. We will meet in the part 2. Okay? Take care.